बुक टू हैरी पॉटर एंड द चेंबर ऑफ सीक्रेट्स चैप्टर वन द वर्स्ट बर्थडे। नॉट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एन आर्ग्यूमेंट हैड ब्रोकन आउट ओवर ब्रेकफास्ट एट नंबर 4 प्राइवेट ड्राइव। मिस्टर वर्नन डर्सली हैड बीन वोकन इन द अर्ली आवर्स ऑफ द मॉर्निंग बाय अ लाउड हूटिंग नॉइज फ्रॉम हिज नेफ्यू हैरीज रूम। थर्ड टाइम दिस वीक ही रोड अक्रॉस द टेबल। इफ यू कांट कंट्रोल दैट आउल इट विल हैव टू गो। Harry tried yet again to explain she is bored. He said, she is used to flying around outside. If I could just let her out at night. Do I look stupid? Snarled Uncle Vernon, a bit of fried egg dangling from his bushy mustache. I know what will happen if that owl's let out. He exchanged dark looks with his wife Petunia. Harry tried to argue back, but his words were drowned by a long, loud belch from the Dursley's son Dudley. I want more bacon, there's more in the frying pan, sweetums, said Aunt Petunia, turning misty eyes on her massive son. We must build you up while we have got the chance. I don't like the sound of that school food. Nonsense, Petunia, I never went hungry when I was at Smelting, said Uncle Vernon heartily. Dudley gets enough, don't you, son? Dudley, who was so large his bottom drooped over either side of the kitchen chair, grinned and turned to Harry. Pass the frying pan. You have forgotten the magic word, said Harry irritably. The effect of this simple sentence on the rest of the family was incredible. Dudley gasped and fell off his chair with a crash that shook the whole kitchen. Mrs. Dursley gave a small scream and clapped her hands to her mouth. Mr. Dursley jumped to his feet, veins throbbing in his temples. I meant please, said Harry quickly. I didn't mean what have I told you, thundered his uncle, spraying spit over the table, about saying the M word in our house. But how dare you threaten Dudley, roared Uncle Vernon, pounding the table with his fist. I warned you I will not tolerate mention of your abnormality under this roof. Harry stared from his purple-faced uncle to his aunt, who was trying to heave Dudley to his feet. All right, said Harry, all right. Uncle Vernon sat back down, breathing like a winded rhinoceros and watching Harry closely out of the corners of his small, sharp eyes. Ever since Harry had come home for the summer holidays, Uncle Vernon had been treating him like a bomb that might go off at any moment because Harry Potter wasn't a normal boy. As a matter of fact, he was as not normal as it is possible to be. Harry Potter was a wizard fresh from his first year at Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. And if the Dursleys were unhappy to have him back for the holidays, it was nothing to how Harry felt. He missed Hogwarts so much it was like having a constant stomach ache. He missed the castle with its secret passageways and ghosts. His classes, though perhaps not Snape the potions master, the mail arriving by owl, eating banquets in the great hall, sleeping in his 4-poster bed in the tower dormitory, visiting the gamekeeper Hagrid in his cabin next to the forbidden forest in the grounds, and especially Quidditch, the most popular sport in the wizarding world, 6 tall goalposts, 4 flying balls and 14 players on broomsticks. All Harry's spellbooks, his wand, robes, cauldron and top of the line Nimbus 2000 broomstick had been locked in a cupboard under the stairs by Uncle Vernon in the instant Harry had come home. What did the Dursleys care if Harry lost his place on the house Quidditch team because he hadn't practiced all summer? What was it to the Dursleys if Harry went back to school without any of his homework done? The Dursleys were what wizards call muggles, not a drop of magical blood in their veins. And as far as they were concerned, having a wizard in the family was a matter of deepest shame. Uncle Vernon had even padlocked Harry's owl Hedwig inside her cage to stop her from carrying messages to anyone in the wizarding world. Harry looked nothing like the rest of the family. Uncle Vernon was large and necklaced with an enormous black mustache. Aunt Petunia was horse-faced and bony. Dudley was blonde, pink and porky. Harry, on the other hand, was small and skinny, with brilliant green eyes and jet black hair that was always untidy. He wore round glasses and on his forehead was a thin lightning shaped scar. It was this scar that made Harry so particularly unusual even for a wizard. The scar was the only hint of Harry's very mysterious past of the reason he had been left on the Dursleys' doorstep 11 years before. At the age of 1 year old, Harry had somehow survived a curse from the greatest dark sorcerer of all time, Lord Voldemort, whose name most witches and wizards still fear to speak. Harry's parents had died in Voldemort's attack, but Harry had escaped with his lightning scar, and somehow nobody understood why Voldemort's powers had been destroyed the instant he had failed to kill Harry. So Harry had been brought up by his dead mother's sister and her husband. He had spent 10 years with the Dursleys, never understanding why he kept making odd things happen without meaning to, believing that Dursley's story had that he had got a scar in the car crash that had killed his parents. Then exactly a year ago, Hogwarts had written to Harry and the whole story had come out. Harry had taken